Over the last year, a lot of YouTubers have been raving about this new Rixu battery. They say they've made tons of strides in the last few years, and they have come a long way from some of the older, scammy, poor quality batteries that they used to make in the past. And we don't have any of those batteries, but we do have our hands on this brand new one, and we're excited to see if it stands up to some of our favorite EG4 server rack batteries on the market right now. So welcome back to the lab, guys, where our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're taking a look at this 48 volt 100 amp hour server rack battery from Rixu. We're just gonna call them R-Bomb. You guys will see why in a little bit. We have had this thing in the lab for about 6 months now, and we feel it's time to share our experience and our thoughts on this battery and if it's worth buying over the EG4 lineup. But you guys know the deal. Before we get into anything else, we're gonna hit you with a super quick 60 second spec teardown to get you up to speed with this R-Bomb 48 volt server rack battery. That's a mouthful. We gotta just start calling it the R-Bomb. First up, it weighs 103 pounds. So again, it passes the tiny baby lift test, but just barely. The server rack batteries are just awkward to pick up. It's a 5,120 watt hour battery bank, 51.2 volts at 100 amp hours. The battery cells are lithium iron phosphate, and these guys are rated for 6,000 cycles at a 90% depth of discharge. And this battery has a massive expandability. You can put up to 32 of these guys together to get you from just the 5.12 kilowatt hours all the way up to 160, which is insane. When it comes to the BMS, it's got some pretty standard protections. We got temperature protections, overcharge, overdraw, that kind of stuff. The basics are in here. And this one is not the self-heating version, though they do have a self-heating version of this battery if you live in a colder climate. And in terms of the design, it's really, really nice to look at, yet it's still a more primitive battery. It's like a 2006 Porsche. It looks amazing, super ahead of its time, but the thing doesn't even have Bluetooth. On the front, you can see we have a ground screw over here. We have our two positive terminals. We have our two negative terminals. You have some dip switches, communication ports. There is no breaker and there is no screen on this battery. All you got is this on and off switch that when it gets cold, it's almost impossible to press because the plastic casing freezes solid. It says it has a 10-year warranty. That is if you can get through to someone for some support. And right now this thing is $1,199, though we usually see it on like a permanent $50 off sale. So most importantly, we wanted to start by testing the R-Bomb. So this battery actually has an interesting surge rating. It says it can do 101 to 119 amps for up to 5 minutes because it's only a 100 amp battery. So we went ahead and put it at 117 amps just underneath that limit. And it actually ran for just over 4 minutes, which is pretty impressive.
There we go. 4 minutes and 15-ish seconds.
And then the second rating it has is 120 to 149 amps, and it says it can do that for 15 seconds. We went ahead and ran it at 140 amps, and it lasted about 5 seconds. Overall, not bad.
That was not 15 seconds.
It never hit what it was rated for, but we also didn't do it at the entry level numbers of what it was rated for. When it comes to efficiency, it's a 100 amp hour battery. We threw a 96 amp load at it. It should have lasted just over 60 minutes, about 62 and a half, and it actually lasted 66 minutes, which is good news. If you have a battery that is not 100% efficient and it is brand new, you did something wrong. We also wanted to temperature test this battery. We live in a cold climate, and if there's ever a situation where this battery ends up getting cold, we want to make sure that the BMS is actually going to do its job and protect the battery. So the cutoff for charging this battery is 0 degrees Celsius, and for discharging, it's negative 20 degrees Celsius. So we wanted to get a real life practical idea of if this would actually work, not just dip the sensors in some cold ass water. So we threw this thing in the deep freezer and we let it sit there for 24 hours and it got down to about negative 25 degrees Celsius. And as soon as we went ahead and turned it on, you could see instantly the alarm light was on. It didn't want to do anything. I did go ahead and plug the charger into it. It wouldn't accept a charge at all. We went ahead, tried to plug it into the inverters. It wouldn't do anything, which is good news. It does protect itself as advertised. And now that it's all thawed out, it still works like normal. When it comes to design of this battery, like we said earlier, it is missing a physical breaker, which I don't like. I like being able to turn the battery on or off with a breaker. I get that it has a little switch right here. It's just weird to me that there is no physical breaker, but everything else on the front is pretty standard stuff. You have all your communication ports. You have more than some of these budget brand batteries typically have on the actual front plate of the battery. When we take a look under the hood, everything is actually really, really nice. Initially, you can see the two shields over all the battery cells. When you go ahead and peel those guys off, there's basically two battery cell packs that you can see are held in there with these two green straps. It all looks really, really well done. Like there's nothing that stands out that looks out of place or like it shouldn't be there. There is to note though, no fire arresters, which again, like lithium iron phosphate should never be a problem, but if you get some of these other batteries, they do come with fire arresters, which is just good like peace of mind stuff. The temperature sensors must be built into the BMS somewhere because normally you would see the temperature sensors kind of glued throughout a battery, so you know that it's taken an accurate temperature reading of the whole thing. This one doesn't seem to have any anywhere. I'm not sure where it's getting those readings from. It still worked perfectly fine, but aside from that, everything under the hood looks great. There's literally just nothing to note here. A couple gripes that we do have with the R-Bomb is honestly, first and foremost, most people that have been making videos on this battery over the last year always say, hey, the battery's great, but we don't know about their support. But you guys know here at the lab, we like to find those things out. We've done videos mystery shopping companies in the past, so we are no stranger to trying to find out what is the support like with a company like this. And I honestly just wish it was better. So there's three ways to contact R-Bomb from their website. The first one is with an email. So Tiny Baby went ahead and shot them an email and said, hey, trying to buy this battery, does it work with some inverter? It was just a random question just to see what they would say. The email instantly kicked back and said that email's invalid. We figured out it's because they spelled battery wrong on their fucking website. So we spelled battery properly, and three full business days later, zero response, which is a little disappointing. The next way that you can contact them is with a phone number. That is a China phone number, I'm pretty sure, right? It's like plus 86 area code. So we went ahead and called that. That one also sucks. And then there's a third option, which I feel the least good about. Just makes me feel weird. It's WhatsApp. And so Tiny Baby shot them a WhatsApp. And yes, they're in China, right? Like most places are. The real issue with talking to someone on WhatsApp is they're trying to talk to you while you're trying to sleep. Yeah, so we hit up Rixu on WhatsApp.
It wasn't, when I dialed it into WhatsApp, it wasn't R-Bomb. It was this girl named who happened to work for R-Bomb, which I just thought was kind of weird. Shot her the question, it was pretty specific. She responded 4 or 5 hours later with yes. And you know, I just kind of R-Bombed her. And then later that night, she's calling me while I'm trying to sleep. My phone's going off, trying to get a hold of me. My girlfriend's like, what is going on? Who is this girl? And I'm like, babe, it's okay. She works for R-Bomb. She works for this battery company. I'm just trying to get an answer to see if this fucking thing works with the inverter that we have in the garage. Long story short, girlfriend's mad at me. This thing works.
Point is, it's just not ideal. If you deal with other companies that have American support, you can get answers and help and warranty problems and all that, like just quickly. You can just call someone, they answer. Even if we got an email back, or even if Tiny Baby decided to text with Rachel, that's one of those things where like you send a text during the day, she replies during the night. You send another text during the day, she replies during the night. It takes like 2 weeks to have a 5-minute conversation. That was our experience with trying to contact them. But moving on from that, to make a decent enough battery, it might be worth the fucking around if you ever have an issue. And so far the battery's not bad. Some of the other things just to note that we just didn't love about this thing, no screen, no app. Why you gotta be a dinosaur? Like we wanna know what is the battery percentage at, what is the amperage at, what are all these things at just by looking at it, and we can't. So that is a little annoying. I just wish there was some way to easily at a glance find out what this thing is up to. There is a lot that we actually like about this battery though. And coming back to the design again, this is slimmer than most server rack batteries. So you'll be able to get more of them in an actual same size rack than some of these other bigger, bulkier Jacoper brands. So we really like that. And sticking to the design, they have these insulated terminals, which are really cool because one, you're not gonna accidentally like zap yourself or anything weird. Two, it makes it really easy to just clip wires on and off of these terminals. Like it's just really handy to be able to walk walk up and pull the wires off. I like that, quick and easy access. And we also like the communication ports being in the middle. A lot of brands put them like weirdly on the side, and there's like a bunch of shit going into one side of the battery, and then the whole front plate is like empty. So we like this when they're on a server rack and they're all stacked, the cables can run up and down the middle. It makes sense. We kind of like the placement of that. We also like that this just works with a ton of different inverter brands. Like any popular inverter that you have, basically this thing should be able to work with and communicate with, which is really nice. The expandability is also a huge one. Up to 32 units of these guys paired together is a massive system. With 160 kilowatt hours, you could probably power tiny baby's tiny house for like 3 years straight with all of his tiny appliances that use tiny amounts of energy. And we also like that there is a heated version of this battery. If you're in an environment like we are, which I don't know why we don't have it, you could get the self-heating one. It's a little bit of extra money, so it's cool that you don't have to buy it, but you can get it. Again, just a huge bonus. And the last thing that we like is, regardless of the fact that there is no contact here in America with Kriexu, they have distribution all over the place. They have them in the US, they have them in Canada, they have them in Australia, they have them in Europe. They have warehouses in all of those places. Dealing with getting product, that kind of stuff, will be much easier in a place where they actually have a warehouse than if it's all coming from some central warehouse super far away. Like, this came within like 2 days, I think, when we ordered it. So in summary, I think it's a good battery. I'm a little bit wishing that they would step up their game in terms of us being able to contact them. That's a huge thing. And a lot of people that are spending thousands of dollars, because if you think about, like, if you're buying this for like a full system, you might be buying 10 of these, right? If you're gonna spend 10 grand on just batteries and you can't call anyone or talk to anyone easily, people are just going to skip over you. They do make a great product though. I think it's good. I would use it in any of my projects. So out of 10, R-Bomb, you get a 7.3. Step it up, get some service, but good job on the batteries. They're actually not bad. That is all I got for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.